Listening for another opinion?
It's an old habit. I'm going to send him home today. His mother can start dreaming his future again.
That's good news.
What is that look? You know I hate that look.
What look?
That Catherine, you must get out more look.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
I know you miss him too. Thank you for being so dear, but I'm fine.
Are you sure you won't come home for dinner with us tonight, Catherine? Marina went all out this year. She made her homemade cranberry sauce and everything.
Oh, thank you. I'd love to come, but I already made plans. Big plans.
Are you sure? You're not just going home and opening a can of something and...
Are you joking? That would require cooking. You know me better than that. Thank Marina for me. Tell her I'll call her later this week.
Okay, but if you change your mind...
Hello, Sarah?
Yes.
Robert Woodward.
Oh, hi.
Yeah, how's she doing today?
Seems to be a good day.
Well, good, good. Yeah, I'm bringing the family over in about an hour. And don't get her dressed. I'm bringing a brand new dress for her to wear.
Oh, she'll love that.
Yeah. Something smells good in there.
Hey, Dad.
I'll bet we're having hot dogs.
On Thanksgiving? It's turkey, Grandpa.
I thought you were coming down to the site with me this morning. You know I hate making decisions alone.
I slept at my daddy's. He didn't wake me up.
I'm sorry, Dad. I forgot to tell Jeff to drop him off. You can go down tomorrow, okay?
Fine, but how do you expect me to run things without my right-hand man, huh? Grandma's gonna love this. Where's your sister? Yes. I want to leave as soon as I change.
Well, either her plane was delayed or she decided to stay in New York to find herself.
Aha!
I'm here and I'm found. Well, good, because I was beginning to think you were going to flake out on us.
Oh, I don't flake out, I get busy.
You're huge. Oh, get busy flaking out.
It's Thanksgiving, be thankful for something. I'm thankful for my favorite nephew.
I'm a Power Ranger.
Good. We need a superhero in the family.
Jacqueline, as soon as I change, we're going to go pick up your mother.
Mom should already be here. Sorry. Dr. Howard, happy Turkey Day.
Same to you, Sarah. How's your daughter?
Oh, she's great. Thank you. You were right. It was just teething.
Good.
What's this?
Treats for the gang.
You shouldn't have.
What are we brewing today?
Orange Pekoe. I figured you might stop by.
You are a lifesaver. I think I'll just go upstairs for a while first.
Sure. Take your time.
Is Mrs. Rogers up?
I think so.
Good.
Stay. We're having turkey later.
Oh, thanks. I have a party to get to.
What'd she bring?
Why does she still come?
Well, she's got pretty close to a few of the patients. She still brings them books and stuff. And she sits in her husband's old room. I think it makes her feel better.
Let's go see Grandma.
Mr. Woodward, I tried to catch you.
Was something wrong?
Mrs. Woodward, we were getting her ready to go and she became very agitated.
What is her heart? Did you call the doctor?
The doctor came a little while ago and gave her something to calm her down. She's fine, but she's still a little...
I want to see Grandma.
Here, you know what? We're going to leave the sign and it's going to be the first...
We're going out. Go show Grandma. Go show me the painting you made. Honey, we're here.
Grandma. I made you this. It's for you coming home. Mom helped me with the words, but I did the pictures.
Isn't that nice? Well, let's put Grandma back to bed.
Yeah, come here.
Come on, dear.
It's snowing on all the animals. Mama says we ought to get him back in the barn.
Yeah, okay. Michael's here with Lori. Jacqueline came home. We came to take you home for Thanksgiving dinner. Yeah, Jacqueline? There, sweetheart.
Hi, Mommy. I missed you so much. I cut my hair again. I know you like it long.
I made your stuffing, Mom. It didn't come out as good as yours.
Here we are. Now, sweetheart, there we go. We'll put you in your new dress, get you home for Thanksgiving dinner. It's your favorite color.
Ah!
It's all right.
Get away from
it's
me!
All right. It's me, Robert.
Ah!
Sweetheart, Jacqueline.
What's wrong, Mom? It's just Daddy.
He's trying to kill me. He's trying to kill me.
It's all right. It's all right.
Dad, what's going on?
She gets confused.
It's okay, Michael. Grandma's just a little upset. She's going to be all right. I'm leaving with Michael.
Take the Suburban. I'm going to stay with your mom.
Dad, come with us. We can all come back here tomorrow. Maybe she'll be feeling...
I'll take a taxi home later.
Dad, you may not be able to get one in this weather.
I'll manage. Go.
Could you grab his coat? Dad.
Go. It's okay.
Okay, sweetheart. Okay, come on. All right, that's fine. Come on. Okay. Now let's get those slippers off.
Can I help you?
I was looking for something to put these in.
Perhaps they have a vase downstairs at the desk.
You don't work here?
No.
Sorry to bother you.
And some water by her bed.
They were her favorites.
Mm.
I don't know if she still remembers that.
Well, it's really coming down out there. You should go home while you still can and get some rest. I'll stay with her.
It was so nice to see you again. I wish you could stay.
Me too.
So where's this party?
Close by. Good thing too, I don't know how far I could get in this weather.
Come on, I've only been here an hour. How could the roads already be... I live in Arlington on Hallbrook Drive. Yeah, I pay the driver double for his trip. Come on, it's Thanksgiving. I have to get home.
Have a wonderful holiday, Sarah. I'll see you soon.
if I don't freeze to death.
I will see you at Christmas.
For sure. Your responsibility.
All right, I'll give him $100. I think that's fair. My family is waiting.
Excuse
it's Thanksgiving.
Me.
I'll be off in a minute.
Yeah, I was going to say.
1 minute.
Could I offer you a lift?
Well, it seems there's only one taxi driver working today. His dispatcher won't let him leave the city.
I live on Gray Knoll. That's not too far from you, I believe.
Really? That's great. Fine.
Hello?
Thanks. Great.
Great.
This is your car?
Yes, it is.
A little impractical, don't you think?
But it appears to be your only opportunity at the moment.
You want me to drive?
Do I seem grossly incompetent to you?
Just trying to be polite.
Really?
Yeah, really. Sorry.
Buckle up.
But don't you think you should have gone straight?
Well, if you want to get stuck behind a snowplow on the freeway for 20 miles.
No, I want to get home as soon as possible.
Well, this is a quicker way.
Notice the doctor's place.
Mm-hmm.
Your husband a doctor?
No. Something wrong with the music?
It's your car.
Indeed. You would prefer country music.
I like jazz. The old stuff. I'd take Sarah Vaughan over anyone today.
Certainly jazz is an important part of our musical history. Sarah Vaughan's vocal facility is unmatched. But I prefer to listen to the instruments, the musical blending.
I just like the sound she makes.
Oh. Unbelievable. I can't believe anybody would do such a stupid thing.
Let's just try to get out of the car, okay?
You blame me?
Oh, no. No, we should have turned left.
You think you could have avoided the accident if you'd been driving?
At this point, I'd just like to get out of the car, okay?
We hit a patch of ice. There's no way anybody could have predicted.
Would you just try to forget about it and please get out of the car?
Right. You could have avoided it.
I'll tell you what. I will bet you $1,000 that I could have avoided it.
How incredibly arrogant. This is a $1 bill.
It's just a metaphor for how I feel. I swear.
I don't take joy in another's adversity.
Oh, dear.
Damn, no cell. Where the hell are we?
It all looks so different in the snow. We can't be far from somewhere.
Oh?
Well, we weren't driving that long. Shelby Manor must be about 10 miles from here.
I say we stay with a totally ridiculous car, run the heater till the snowplows reach this shortcut from hell.
Good idea. You stay with a totally ridiculous car, which happens to be a classic antique. I have responsibilities.
Carving a turkey and serving mashed potatoes to relatives isn't exactly an emergency. We don't die, I'm gonna kill her.
There's got to be something around here. We're not exactly in the wilderness.
No, then we'd be lost.
Has anybody ever told you that you're a real pain in the ass?
Are you okay?
Thank you, I'm all right.
Are you sure?
I'm fine. There's got to be a farm.
Yeah, unless the farm burned down and the only thing left is the tractor.
You're a half-empty kind of guy, aren't you?
No, I live in the real world where people don't drive Jaguars in the snow.
No key.
McCarthy.
Really?
Rehabilitated. Well, hop on.
Where?
How much do you weigh?
None of your business.
Now hang on.
Wait, wait! I lost my necklace. I have to find it.
That's fine. We'll come back in June, have a scavenger hunt and a barbecue. Right now, we're low on fuel, and it's below zero. What the... That ought to do it.
My husband gave me that necklace for our 20th wedding anniversary.
I'm sorry. The hyperthermia.
Hypothermia.
My mistake. Hang on. Hi.
Can't you go faster? I could walk faster.
Okay, then get off.
When did Mom get so bad? You said she was doing okay.
Well, that was 4 months ago. You haven't been home in a while. So, how's it going with Brick, the model?
His name is Brock, and he is not a model. He's a male mannequin.
What's that language he speaks?
It's English.
Oh, really? Hi, yeah, this is Lori Campbell, Mary Beth Woodward's daughter.
Hi.
Is my father still there?
No, he got a ride. While
ago. Okay, thank you. Well, Dad got a ride a little while ago. He should be home soon.
Mom's never coming home, is she?
Some days she seems just fine. And others, she's just lost. I made her a photo album just to help her remember who we all are.
Why didn't anyone tell me how bad she is? I should have been here.
Stop fighting. You're here now, and that's what matters. Come on, mash these potatoes. That turkey's ready.
Good, I'm starving.
Why? You never eat anything.
I eat. I just got Dad's metabolism and you got Mom's.
That's right. I'm the short, fat sister.
You're not fat. You're pregnant.
Well, thank you. That means a lot coming from my tall, thin sister.
You're being hormonal.
Oh, that's it. Hormones. My life would be perfect except for those hormones.
Sorry. It's Mommy's favorite bowl.
It's all right.
No, it's not. It's the one she got in Italy.
She won't care.
You've been cut!
Yeah, I did it starting the tractor.
Let me see.
It's nothing. I'll live. Look, I think we're safe.
Oh, thank God.
You may be serving that turkey yet.
Hey!
Hey! Don't you ask who it is, huh? How's my big boy, huh?
Watched the whole parade on TV. None of the balloons fell down this year.
Really? Well, maybe next year.
Jeff.
You invited me, remember?
I know. I just thought you were dead.
What, he's not here? Where is he?
He's on his way back from seeing Mom.
Well, not unless he's on a snowplow. I barely made the mile and a half from my place in my Rover.
All right. Come on.
I'm okay. Entering is against the law, or didn't you learn that from your probation officer?
Maritime law says that when lost at sea, any unoccupied port is a safe zone.
You were in the Marines and prison. How comforting.
Well, I'll make a fire. Maybe you could look for a phone, some more candles, maybe. Storm knocked the power out.
It's dead.
Yeah, I know. I already tried it.
Then why did you ask me to look for a phone? Never mind. I don't care.
Your devoted husband will just have to wait for you to surface.
My husband died of prostate cancer a year ago.
I'm sorry. Occasionally I say the wrong thing.
I noticed that right away.
I'll go out and look for some wood to make that fire.
So that's it? We don't even try to get help? We just give up and stay here?
No, not at all. I'll stay here by the fire. You go out into the blizzard and search for signs of life. Bring me back some marshmallows.
Oh, please.
Look, it's just till tomorrow morning. And then we can leave some money for the broken windows and we'll Goldilocks it out of here. I'm Robert Woodward. I guess if we're sleeping together, we should know each other's names.
Catherine Howard.
I'll go find some wood and trap a bear.
Good. You go hunt and gather. I'll knit something for the harvest.
Why did you give me a ride?
Because I was looking for a nightmarish adventure in the snowy wilderness.
No, really.
Why did you offer me a ride?
Because I recognize the look.
What look?
The look that says I love my mate more than anything in the world, but if I spend one more minute in this place watching him suffer, I'll scream.
Was that that obvious? Why didn't you tell me you found the wood?
And deny you the chance to prove your manhood?
Touché.
A low pressure system unexpectedly moved up from the south, and this is why we have snow and blowing snow. We're up to 2.5 feet already.
How long ago did he leave?
At least an hour.
Authorities are recommending you stay off the roads. Very slippery conditions. Visibility in some areas is
nil. You know your dad. I'm sure he's pulled over and waited out in the suburban. He'll probably redevelop the whole area by morning.
The suburban's here. We drove it home.
Got to ride with somebody.
As I mentioned, over 50 miles.
Well, what are you doing?
I'm going to go look for him.
I thought you said you barely made it here.
It'll be all right with the four-wheel drive.
Well, then I'm going too.
No, just stay with Michael. I'll call as soon as I find him.
He's my father. I'm going.
My God, Laura, you're 7 months pregnant. Would you stop fighting me for 2 minutes?
I'm not fighting you. I'm going with you.
I'll stay with Michael.
Thank you.
Now I insist on looking at that wound.
Oh, come on. It's just a scratch.
Come and sit down right here.
Yeah. Look, I mean, there's really more blood than anything.
Let's have a look.
Just a second. There we go.
That's pretty deep. When did you last have a tetanus shot?
Should I know that?
I'll disinfect and dress it for now. You should see your doctor as soon as you get home. Sorry.
Ah. The license plates. They're yours, right? You're the doctor.
Pediatric cardiologist.
An impressive doctor.
Here, put your fingers on that.
Oh, you must be freezing. You really should get out of those wet things. Let's go take a shower. I'm sure they have a bathrobe or something you'd change into.
A cold shower and a stranger's robe. How can I resist?
The water should be hot. It's gas.
Really?
Did you ever see Psycho?
Yes, why?
No reason.
Chef at the penitentiary?
I used to make this for my girls on the nights my wife, Mary Beth, went to school.
What did she study?
She taught art to underprivileged children.
Feed the body food and drink, it will survive today. Feed the soul
art and music, it will live forever. She had that up in her classroom.
Really? It's one of my favorite quotes. I never really learned to cook. I guess I didn't have that much interest in it. Tom, my husband, was very patient with me. We ordered out a lot.
Mary Beth is a great cook. She's Irish Catholic, but she cooks Italian. I took her to Italy on our 10th wedding anniversary. Fell in love with garlic. Oh, look what I found. I think they left it for us.
Is that who you're visiting today at the hospice, your wife?
Yes.
How's she doing?
Fine. Well, dinner, such as it is served.
You set the table. You're very domesticated for a male chauvinist.
And you are looking very beautiful for a woman who's given up on being one. Ah, that was out of line. That was way out of line.
No, that's okay. What did you mean?
I never should have opened my big mouth.
Please, I'd like to know what you meant.
Well, women have different looks. They're subtle, but men can read them very clearly. There's available, unavailable, unavailable except for the right guy.
And what am I in your educated opinion?
You're the easiest to read of all. Ice, high walls, guns drawn, unavailable, uninterested, don't look, don't try.
That is so absolutely not true. I think I'm a very warm person.
Well, if you put on a dress, wear your hair just a little softer, men will notice you hiding in there.
I'm not interested in being noticed.
I didn't mean to embarrass you.
You didn't. Your children used to eat this? Didn't they make a fuss?
Yes, but then we can't order out for Sal's genuine Italian pizza. That's what they used to do.
Tell me about them.
Well, Jacqueline is the youngest. She's the free spirit artist. Works in a gallery in Soho. Lori, the older one, ironically, is separated from a divorce lawyer. He's a great guy. They've been together for years. They'll work it out. Lori and her son, staying with me right now, Michael, he's my best pal. Huh. Did you ever have any
grandchildren? No, we never had children of our own.
I guess being a doctor didn't give you much time.
No, I prayed for a child. God answered me. The answer was no.
Maybe you weren't meant to have your own. Maybe you were supposed to save one special one. One who might save the world. Invent a cure for your husband's cancer.
Thank you. I'd never thought of it that way. Here. True normal.
Okay. That's wonderful. I thought you said you didn't cook.
Well, it's Thanksgiving. I thought I'd make the effort.
I'm gonna have to go fix that shutter. I'm gonna end up breaking the window. Just one for the road.
You okay?
I'm fine.
You should have stayed at the house.
I thought you had to work tonight.
I did. I left early.
It was nice of you to fit us in.
For one day, can you just stop?
It meant a lot to Michael that you came tonight. He needs to know you still love him.
My son knows that I love him.
I guess that's the least we should be able to hope for from our parents.
It's my job, Lori, all right? I'm not out having fun, I'm working. If I don't put in a lot of hours, then I don't make partner.
You can still work and have a life with your family.
I'll be there for Michael. I'm gonna be in my son's life no matter what.
I'm glad I didn't do that.
Your mom used to call me Butterfingers.
How come we don't have to wait for everyone before we eat?
They told us to go ahead.
Before Daddy got his own apartment, Mommy used to make us wait till he got home to eat with us. Sometimes we didn't eat till late.
Your grandma did that sometimes. Your mom and I used to wait until your grandpa got home, too.
What's wrong with Grandma?
She's just tired. She's tired of remembering everything and tired of doing all the things that she's been doing all her life.
Is she tired of me?
No, honey. You know why she still remembers how to smile.
You know, this cabin must be 50 years old. Could you hold this for me, please?
Okay. Like that?
Yeah, that's good.
Watch the hand, please.
Yes, doctor. Howard and Millie Binkow must really be old.
Who?
A couple who own this place. Howard built it years ago. They come down here once a year on Thanksgiving, and they sit by the fire, eat their dinner, play a little Scrabble. Millie plays the ukulele, and then they go to bed.
That's the best you can do?
Oh, you can do better.
Yeah, I think so. Their names are Charlie and Robin. Charlie's dad built this place years ago. Charlie's bringing his new bride down here for their very first Thanksgiving. They plan to light 1,000 candles.
And burn the cabin down.
Excuse me, this is my story now. They're going to listen to Sinatra all night long. Charlie likes to accompany Frank on the ukulele. Scrabble is something they play between eating and making love.
You have a very active imagination for a woman of science.
And you're very sensitive for an ex-felon, marine pessimist.
Yay. I'm gonna need you to hold this from out here.
Oh, okay, hold on.
Are you gonna be long?
I'm coming! Here I am.
All right, don't slip. I've almost got it finished.
Here?
Yeah, right there. You know, I'm a builder.
No, you're not.
Oh, I'm not?
I've seen your hands. Those aren't the hands of a builder.
Well, I don't actually mix concrete. I used to. I just don't do it anymore. Now, I just point.
Oh.
There.
You got me out here just for that?
Yeah. Sorry.
Oh, I'm fine. Steady hands, clumsy feet. Hey, put me down.
It's freezing out here. I want to get inside.
I'm perfectly capable of walking.
We both know that's not true.
I'm wondering how many times you have offended me today.
I call them like I see them.
Honestly, that's so refreshing in an ex-con.
Would you get that door, please?
I haven't been picked up since I was a little girl.
That's a shame. You need picking up. I'm sorry. R-A-V-E-L, unravel. That's 12 points and the lead.
Q-U-I, Z-blank-Z-E-S. That's
50 points and the game.
50? Horse pucky.
Double letter, double word.
Damn, you are competitive for a woman.
You have a lot of ideas about what a woman should be like.
You break a lot of my preconceptions.
Why, because I beat you? Because I'm a doctor?
No, because you're smart and tough, without being afraid to be feminine. Women seem to have a hard time with that. Your husband was a lucky man.
Thank you.
You know, I will bet you chocolate chip pancakes at Murray's that that's spelled incorrectly.
You eat at Murray's?
Every day on my way to work.
Oh, that is so odd. We live in the same area, we go to the same restaurant, and yet we never, ever met.
Reverse fate. Have you ever had the chocolate chip pancakes?
I'm an adult.
Well, I'm a little embarrassed to order them when I'm alone, so I bring my grandson along, let him order. They're so wonderful, I can't describe them.
I can't wait to try them, if we live.
I want to see the look on your face when you take that first bite. So I'll meet you there this Sunday. We'll eat chocolate chip pancakes and thank God we're alive.
It's a date.
All right, we'll play one more game. I'll spot you about.
I think I'll quit while I'm significantly ahead. What time is it?
It is after midnight.
We should get some rest. You take the bedroom. I'm going to stay here right on the couch. I'm used to getting very little rest.
Oh, no, no. If I go to sleep now, I'm afraid I won't get up. And I'm not about to climb that ladder. And what would it look like if Millie came in, found you asleep on the couch in her room? How would Howard explain that?
Okay, we stay up all night and wait to be rescued. You said your daughter, Jacqueline, works in a gallery. What kind of gallery?
Modern art. She's a painter herself.
I used to paint badly.
Mary Beth says art is emotion.
I used to paint trees a lot. I love trees. Loved to climb them as a child. My mother said I was probably a monkey in another life. I'm sorry, I ramble in non sequiturs sometimes.
I'll bet you were cute as a child.
Not at all. I was skinny like a beanpole, had bandy legs, a lazy eye.
I wore braces and glasses and spoke with a lisp. We would have been a match made in heaven.
Pity we didn't meet as children.
I'm just gonna see if they heard anything.
There was no sign of him on the main road, and he didn't come back to the hospice. They say he left in a sports car, a small Jag or something.
That can't be good.
But we're not giving up yet. How's Michael doing?
He's asleep. I didn't tell him anything.
Good. All right, look, we're gonna try another route back to the house and keep looking.
Okay. Call me.
Okay.
I don't have much left to give Mary Beth, except staying with her right now.
I'm sure she needs you as much as you need her.
She's not fine. She's not getting better. I lied. She had 3 heart attacks in the last 11 months. Her heart was compromised by the Alzheimer's. At least that's what they say this week. Truth is, she doesn't know me anymore. She just sees some stranger who comes to visit.
She knows you.
How do you know that?
In her soul. A woman never forgets a man who's occupied her heart for so long. Tom was older than I by 15 years. He was awfully good to me. He never seemed to mind if I had to get up from dinner, in the middle of the movies, in the middle of the night. Take this time with Mary Beth, it's precious. I know, I've been there.
I'm just gonna grab a couple of winks.
Okay. I'll take the first watch.
They had to have come this way.
I can't even see the road. Oh, my God.
That's got to be the car.
It's empty. There's no one here.
Oh, thank God.
They must have taken off on foot.
Oh, it's just like my father.
I'm gonna go look for them. Just wait in the car.
No, I'm going with you.
No, Lori, it's cold, all right?
I'm going with you.
Robert? 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 Robert?
Thank you for this.
That's my husband's.
I'm sorry. I found it in your car.
I bought those for him just before he got sick. I guess I forgot about them.
Well, these are hard to get.
A friend of mine gets them for me. You may have met him in prison.
I walk back to the car. It's dead.
Now what?
Well, the snowplow came through. I think I know where we are. So as soon as I warm up a little, I'll hike back up the main road, see if I can hitch a ride. What's wrong?
I'm sorry. It's the smell. It reminds me so of Tom.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't realize.
It's okay.
It's funny about smells. How they take you back. I went to the department store and I tried every perfume they had, trying to find the one that Mary Beth wore. One day I'm walking up Lexington and I smell her. I followed this lady for 3 blocks. Asked her what she was wearing. Turned out it was her shampoo. I missed my wife's hair and I didn't even know it.
That's dear. She would love knowing that.
Thank you. I like talking to you. I want to know all about you. Catherine?
I know. It was just one special night. But thank you for helping me discover that life can still be pleasant.
Maybe someday in the future.
Who knows?
Dad? 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 Dad?
I can't believe you found that cabin. Do you know how lucky you were?
It saved our lives.
We would have been fine.
We would have frozen to death.
You're a half-empty kind of gal, aren't you?
No, I just live in the real world, where snow melts and life goes on.
I left some money for Howard and Millie.
Who?
Charlie and Robin.
We'll have to send a tow truck for your car. It's buried pretty deep.
Oh, it's a silly car for this kind of weather. It was a gift from my father when I graduated medical school. I went to UCLA. They don't have weather there.
Wow, it's that old. Not that you're. I just meant it's a classic. It's got to be worth a fortune.
Oh, it is. My father gave it to me. There. On the left, that long drive.
That's your house?
Yes.
I used to walk by here every day on my way to school. You give out great candy on Halloween.
Oh, I love spoiling the children in my neighborhood. Thank you for rescuing us. I'm forever in your debt.
Well, I owe you after all those Hershey bars.
Oh, bye.
Bye-bye.
I'll walk you to the door.
No. Stay there. I'm fine.
Oh, Catherine. I never really spent time in prison.
Just as I was beginning to believe everything you told me.
I'll never lie to you again, I swear.
I'll bet you $1,000 you can't keep that promise.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
So what happened between you two?
Nothing. We were stuck in the snow together.
She's beautiful.
is she?
Hello, is this Dr. Howard? Any messages?
No, you're all clear.
Good. Okay, I'm home if anybody needs me.
Very good, Dr. Howard.
Thank you.
I was really worried about Dad.
Well, turns out that he was snug as a bug in a... whatever.
When did we get old enough to have to worry about our parents? God, I hate it. It's freaky.
Yeah, freaky.
What's that supposed to mean?
Nothing.
What?
Nothing.
That's not nothing.
You call home occasionally for an update. You worry 5,000 miles and 5,000 other thoughts away from here.
You chose to live here. Nobody's forcing.
No, I choose to be a grown-up. I go see Mom every day. I sit with her while she calls me Mona and asks me to bring her her skates. I watch Dad feed her and dress her as if she were a child. No, I don't worry about them. I'm part of them. I'm in their lives.
It's not your job. You don't have to take care of them.
I don't just take care of them. Forget it.
What?
That is not just some woman wandering around lost out there. It's Mommy. You remember her? The woman who drove 600 miles to summer camp to bring you Mr. Fluffy after you swore you wouldn't need him? Oh, when you were six? And you were crying because you decided you were too tall to be a fairy princess. No, I'm not here because I have to be. I'm here because they're Mom and Dad. And I'm not finished needing them.
I was really worried about you.
Well, thank you, sweetheart.
I've decided I'm gonna stay a while, if that's all right with you.
Sure, honey. Be great having you and your sister home. Be like old times. What about your work?
I can take some time off.
Great, great. I have to get down to the site before I go visit your mom.
I'm sorry that I wasn't here more. I guess I was afraid.
She knows how much you love her.
Can't lose her.
Oh, honey, honey. It's
okay. Hello?
Hello, Catherine, dear. It's Marina.
Oh, hi, Marina.
Yes,
I had a fine Thanksgiving. Well, tell me all about yours.
We got a house full.
Uh-huh.
10 of them underage. Oh.
Really? William told me. Uh-huh. Sounds delicious. What are you doing? He's not going to be there.
She's not going to be there anyway.
Dr. Howard.
Oh, it's Catherine.
I haven't seen you in such a long time. I see you, I still expect to see Mr. Howard.
I know.
I'm sorry, I shouldn't have said
no,
that.
No, it's okay.
Table for one today?
Actually, I'm expecting to meet somebody, I think.
Come, I'll give you a table. You can have some coffee and read the Sunday papers while you're waiting for her.
Him. Do you still make chocolate chip pancakes?
Absolutely.
Good. Thank you.
Hello?
Dad, Mom's had another attack.
What?
They're taking her to the hospital.
When?
Now. Please hurry. It's bad.
Yeah, I'll be right there.
Aunt Jacqueline says it makes me look cool.
It's just a clip-on. You don't want to have to look cool all the time.
Nobody does.
You don't have to do it now.
Yes, I do.
Now let me help you.
No. Thank you. I've gotten used to doing things by myself.
So this is it, Lori? You and I are over because I wasn't home enough? Our family is destroyed because I wasn't paying enough attention? I am trying harder.
How dare you? How dare you think I would risk losing my family for your job?
Well, that's what you're doing, isn't it?
Do you really think I'm that stupid? Do you really think I didn't know about Heather?
You never said anything.
I was hoping you would.
It's over, Lori. I promise you, it's been over. I am so sorry.
I thought we were a family.
I don't get another chance. I love you, Lori. I always have. I made a terrible mistake, and it's never gonna happen again. I'll do whatever it takes to make things right. Please, Lori. I'll take Michael back to my house. Give you a chance to be with your family.
Thank you.
Christmas.
Oh, William, Merry Christmas.
Look different.
I do.
Remember you, Eggnog?
Sure.
Party's a great success.
Oh, I think they've done a wonderful job this year. William, could I ask you something?
Sure.
What impression do I give as a woman?
I don't know what you mean.
This is so silly. I mean, do I appear to you to be available, unavailable? Available but not really, or unavailable but...
Are you sure you haven't been getting into the eggnog?
Cheers.
Doctor's Exchange.
Hi, this is Dr. Howard. Any messages?
No, you're all clear. Have a Merry Christmas.
Thank you. Merry Christmas to you, too.
Just breathing in and out again. Keep it short, keep it simple, they say. But hard as I try to keep this point of view.
Here we go, big guy.
Seeing you. Never knew how easily my life would change after one special moment with you. And the mornings that start off with seeing you. Ooh.
Sarah on duty?
She has a kid, so she got Christmas Eve and Christmas off. I'm just filling in.
Of course. I was wondering, has Mary Beth Woodward's family come in to visit her today? It's not important. I just wanted to thank...
I'm sorry. There doesn't seem to be a Mary Beth Woodward here anymore. She must have gone home.
Oh. I see. I think I'll just go upstairs for a little while.
Are you here to visit someone?
Oh, no, no, no. I just like to sit in my husband's old room. The one he was in when he was here.
I'm sorry. All the rooms are occupied right now. We had several new patients check in this week.
Oh. I understand. Thank you. Okay, I'm on my way. Okay, Corey. What do we have?
Premature labor, 34 weeks. Separation of placenta causing fetal distress. We need to do a stat section.
Is she prepped?
Catherine. Yes, she is.
Robert.
I asked for you. It's my daughter, Lori. She's early and they say the baby isn't doing well.
I'll get back to you as soon as I can.
Yes, Catherine. Okay, she'll be all right.
Hi, Norman.
I'm glad you're here.
Hello, Lori. It's Dr. Howard. I'm a pediatric cardiologist. Your dad sent for me.
He told me. I'm so scared.
Oh, you're going to be just fine. You're in good hands.
But it's too soon. I still have 3 weeks.
Well, maybe this one's anxious to get here.
Lori?
I'm sorry, you have to wait outside.
No, I have to be
I'm
with my
sorry,
wife.
Jeff.
Okay, Carrie.
The IO
entrance.
Doctor, she's ready.
Hi. I'm so proud of you.
I know.
I love you, Lori. You have to forgive me.
I do?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Table. Lamp. Suction. Lamp. Baby's here. Suction.
Get the isolate ready.
Lamp. Scissors. Okay, let's dry her up.
Doctor, is he okay?
What's the heart rate?
Heart rate 70. Starting cardiac massage.
Good.
Here you go. After you get
more oxygen, just come up. Jeff, I don't hear anything.
Is everything all right?
Good. Good. Keep working.
Doctor, is he okay?
Good. She's pinking up.
Mm-hmm.
I think she's gonna make it.
Jeff. You have a daughter. A lovely daughter.
Hi there.
She's beautiful.
She is so beautiful.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Robert, she's going to be fine. We had to do a C-section, but everything went well.
The baby?
Fine, we got her out in time.
A girl, that's great. Is she okay?
Oh, I don't see any long-term problems. I want neonatal to keep an eye on her overnight, but just as a precaution. She's a beautiful little girl.
Thank God. I hope you didn't mind me calling you.
Oh, it's my job.
How have you been?
Good, fine. You?
Okay. I was hoping I'd run into you.
Really?
Did you go? Last Sunday we were supposed to meet. Did you go for chocolate chip pancakes?
Oh, you know what? I forgot. I got so busy.
Oh.
Did you?
I was there.
You were? You were there?
Yes.
At Murray's on Main on Sunday?
Yes. I got called away, but I was there.
I have to go.
When can I see you?
I don't know. It's a very busy time of year.
I know I should have called, but...
Oh, I understand. I have to go.
I'm going away for Christmas, my vacation home. Maybe when I get back?
Sure.
Catherine! She may be the one. Special child you were meant to save.
Well, it's Christmas Eve. It's the right night for it.
Merry Christmas, Dr. Howard.
Merry Christmas.
She's beautiful, thanks to you.
No, I didn't do much. How are you?
I'm a little sore. He's exhausted.
I bet. Actually, he was pretty brave in there. You must be proud. What did you name her?
Mary Beth. After my mother.
Oh, that's sweet. How is she?
My mom? Well, she died the Sunday after Thanksgiving.
The Sunday after Thanksgiving? I'm so sorry. I didn't realize.
I felt her here with me all night.
I'm sure she was. Get some rest. I'll have one of the nurses stop by and check on you and the baby.
Oh, I'm fine. We're fine.
I'll check on you first thing in the morning. He was there. You are such an idiot. Stupid, stupid, stupid.
Merry Christmas, Dr. Howard.
Merry Christmas, Sally.
They make you work on Christmas?
No. I just came by to check on a patient.
She's doing great.
Hmm?
I was just going to take her to her mother. It's time for her feeding.
I'll do it.
Thanks.
Oh, Merry Christmas.
There she is.
I hope you don't mind. They brought Christmas to me and the baby.
Oh.
Oh, look.
Hi.
That's your Auntie Jacqueline.
You're here. They said you weren't on call today.
Well, I had a special patient. Hello, Michael.
Hi.
So, you have a brand new baby sister, huh?
She looks like me when I was a baby.
Oh, you must be Jacqueline.
Hi.
Hi.
You're right. She is the Hershey lady.
Told you. I walked past your house this morning.
I was here looking for you. I have a present for you. It's in my car.
You do?
Walk out with me.
Would you excuse us? Robert, I was there that Sunday at the restaurant. I waited and I tried the chocolate chip pancakes. They were delicious.
Open it.
Where did you find this?
Piece of cake.
But it's exactly like the one I lost in the snow.
That is the one you lost in the snow.
I can't believe you do this.
And I found this. It's Chanel. I took it with me to the department store. 100 women smelled it.
100 women?
That's just a metaphor. Can you get away? There's something I want to show you.
It's Christmas morning.
I'll drive.
Why? Do I seem grossly incompetent to you in some way?
No. I thought about you a lot.
When you didn't call, it seemed that maybe...
I wanted to call. I just felt it was a little too soon.
I don't believe this.
I can't believe this happened twice.
I had nothing to do with it this time.
You stay in the car. I'll go for help.
No, you stay in the car. I have responsibilities. People depend on me. Find my way back here. I always got lost.
Well, I spend a lot of time here.
Really? If you stranded us here on purpose, it was a waste of time. Charlie and Robin are home, it seems.
Well, maybe Howard and Millie will let us in to warm up.
Robert, you can't barge in on people on Christmas morning. Mustn't interrupt, Robert.
I'm sure they'll be happy to see us.
They're probably afraid to answer the door. Robert? He's crazy. Huh.
Where are Charlie and Robin?
Howard and Millie moved to Florida. The place was for sale.
This is your vacation home? You bought it?
Yeah, just for an emergency, in case I ever got stranded again. Do you believe in second chances?
I'm a woman of science. I only believe in what I see.
Merry Christmas, Millie.
Merry Christmas, Howard.
Thank you.